Quarantine and the coronavirus hasn't been the most fun thing, but if there's one silver lining, it's that in our city, the golf courses have been open the entire time.
Yeah, and so, they have not closed.
Yeah, so we've been able to golf the entire time, and now it's junior golf season, and Lincoln's done how many tournaments now?
Probably like 10.
10 golf tournaments? So he's already played through 10 golf tournaments, and we thought that it would be a good time to do what's inside Lincoln's golf bag. And while we're at it, we'll show you what's inside of our bags also. And so, Lincoln, you want to show him your golf bag?
Okay.
Okay, here comes Lincoln's golf bag. What's inside of it? Watching my step.
So this is my golf bag. I really like this one because it's really good for carrying. There's lots of padding and stuff. And it's a really light bag, and you still can fit a lot in it.
That has like my name, LM, engraved on it, which is pretty cool.
These are my clubs right here. So this is my driver. Got a nice little Royal Melbourne head cover that we got when we went there. So I use a Titleist TS2 with 9.5 degree loft. So the shaft of my driver is stiff and it is 55 grams. Yeah, so that is my driver. Lately I've just been hitting 3-wood and my 3-iron hybrid off the tee. Here's another cool head cover, Torrey Pines. We went there for the Farmers Insurance Pro-Am. I got this head cover.
And the champions of the North Course, the Jason Kokrak. Woo!
There you go, boys.
This is a TS2 15 degree 3-wood.
And to Lincoln's credit, he's been hitting this thing a lot of times further than the other kids that are hitting drivers.
Which is pretty cool.
And it's getting you in the fairway.
Yeah, my driver is actually going about 230 right now because it's such a big slice, and this is going about 230 to 240, which, I mean, if I'm hitting the fairway 9 out of 10 times, can't complain much about that. So in the tournament, if it's like a more wide open hole, I do hit the 3-wood, but if not, I hit my 3-iron hybrid, very consistent, 19 degree, TS2 also, my 4-iron hybrid. This one I don't hit that much. My 3-iron hybrid, that goes about 320. This one goes about, 320, ha. My 3-iron hybrid goes about 220. This club goes about 200 to 210, if I hit it good.
Man, that thing is worn down. You've used that so much.
I hit one shot on the rocks with it once.
Oh, like, geez.
And I hit it and it did like half of this damage. I hit it so good. And then I looked back at my club, trying to put the head cover back on. And I was like, oh my gosh. So for the irons, I have P790s, TaylorMade. They're like in between a blade and a regular club, which I really like. I really hit these good. I love my irons.
These are some really popular clubs from last year.
Yeah.
They kind of do look like blades, except they have that. They do have the bump on there, and I guess it's foam injected, so there's some sort of foam inside of it.
Pretty fancy.
And it just makes it hit really nice.
Yeah, look how dirty it is.
Lincoln, so far, how do you feel about the golf tournaments you've been in?
Of course, it's golf. It could have been better with every one of them. But, okay, pretty good.
Do you think the TrackMan has helped you? We've had it for a while now.
Yes, it really has. Just like knowing my yardages and just like coming in here and swinging, especially like at night, you know?
After you swing a club and you hit a ball well, do you look like that?
No, I wish. I wish.
Work on that right there.
So I have P790s from my gap wedge to my 5-iron. So 9, 8, 7, 6, 5 gap wedge, pitching wedge. They all are P790s. And for my wedges, I have Cleveland RT6 4s. So I have a 60 degree lob wedge and a 56 degree sand wedge. I just barely got this Spider TaylorMade putter. It looks so good. I love the look of the Spider, Spider X. I really like with this putter how it has a really long line on the top of it. It really helps you align your ball when you're lining up your putts. I have a Super Stroke grip on this putter. I've never really had a bigger grip on my putter. So I just barely got this putter and I've been really testing it out and just switching out in between some tournaments I played with this. And this is the putter that I've had for I think 7 years now. So I really love this putter. This is a Scotty Cameron Select Newport 2. I really like the feel of the Scotty. It really just like pushes the ball forward. Because it's so heavy, it really connects with the ball well.
How's your putting game been in the last few tournaments?
Last few tournaments, it's been a little bit rough. It's been getting a lot better. So that's another thing that I've been working on. That, my
My driver and my putting is probably my two worst things right now that I've really been practicing.
Because he's hitting a 3-iron hybrid and his 3-wood so incredibly well, he's getting it in the fairway almost every time, where some people are getting more distance on him, but he's so consistent in the fairway, and he's doing a decent job of getting on the green, but his putting has been the challenge. So that's why he's been like switching back and forth, trying to figure out which putter is gonna work for him, and then once he figures it out, he's gonna stick with that one and really practice, because if he eliminated even half of the 3 putts and even a couple of 4 putts, he would be scoring so much lower in these tournaments. I don't need to say the 4 putts. Let's pretend like those don't even exist.
It's one tournament.
It was just one tournament. He had 2 of them in a 9-hole stretch, and it was like, oh no. And he only shot 13 over for the tournament, and he had 42 putts. So the putting is something he's working on.
That's not good. That's not what you want.
No, it's not what you want.
42 putts in 18 holes? That's terrible.
Yeah. I really like your bag. It's just clean. It's that white, like fake leather stuff, so it's waterproof.
Yeah.
Keeps everything dry inside of there. So now let's see like what's really inside of your bag.
All right, so we can start off with the type of golf ball that I use. I use TaylorMade Pix TP5, and I draw a little blue line on my balls. I like this ball because it's really good for putting.
Most golf balls have like a little line on the top of it, like pretty much all of them do. But what makes this one really cool is that with these orange lines, once you line it up and then you hit your putt, if you really hit it solid, you should see 2 orange lines going as the ball's rolling toward the hole. And it just shows that you really hit it right. If you like opened your face or you came across it or something, you're not gonna see that perfect roll. And it kind of gives you an indicator like, okay, I'm not hitting my putts directly along the line that I wanted. A lot of people use the Titleist Pro V1s. That's what this ball is similar to. It spins really, really well on the greens. You can hit it far. You have a lot of control with it. Where they also have the TP5X.
Yes.
And that ball is like the Pro V1X. So a lot of people stick with the Pro V1s and they're like, these are the greatest balls because everybody on tour uses them. Well, not everybody uses them. The TaylorMade TP5s are really good golf balls.
Yeah.
I use the TP5s without these little triangles on them, without the Ricky Fowler. I don't use the Pix, P-I-X balls.
Yeah.
Lincoln uses the Pix, but we both use the same ball. And it's really cool during his golf tournaments because almost nobody has this kind of golf ball.
And even if they do, they won't have a blue line on it. And it's so nice because for identifying your ball, because like lots of people TaylorMade their Titleist balls and say it's like turned upside down. Like you can't see what
ball.
It is. Yeah. So,
he just walks up to his ball and he knows like, oh, there's the orange pizza ball. That one's Lincoln's.
Or if I do hit it inside the water, I'm like, there's my ball. That's how close it was. So this is inside my other pocket. I have a glove inside of it because my golf coach today, he said, if your gloves are getting worn out really fast, put it inside of a Ziploc bag because then it keeps the moisture inside. This is my ball marker bag. I always make sure that I have ball markers in the tournament.
Hold on a second. Pour some of these out on the table. I want to see these.
All right. So those are my ball markers right there. Got some pretty random ones. This is from the Hoover Dam. I found it inside my room and I'm like, that would be a great ball marker.
That's when we went to the Hoover Dam and did that video?
Yeah. This is from a golf course I usually play at a lot. Sun River Golf Club. I didn't have a ball marker one day and I was like, I need to go buy one. So just got this little hat clip too. Hat clips are very nice. Lots of quarters and dimes and pennies. This one, Link Soul. This is a very fancy ball marker. Someone inside the Pro-Am gave to me because I didn't have a ball marker.
And you just kept it?
Yeah, he said you can have it. And I was like, sweet, thanks. It's a really nice ball
marker.
The
cool thing is, Link Soul, this is the hat that I have on right now. And I bought this because I didn't know Link Soul was a brand, but it says, make par, not war. But the way that I took it as, make par, Link. So whenever you're in a golf tournament, you can't really talk to the kids and like be a caddy. But I can, if he gets a bogey or if he hits a good shot, I can be like, make par, Link. I can just point to my hat, make par, Link.
This one's really funny. This is the Almo. And on the back, it says, remember the Almo. Because why not?
Okay, let me explain on that one. The Remember the Alamo, that is my ball marker that I used for the Pro-Am back when I played with Harris English. So like right here, Harris English. It was funny because Harris English, it was like the 6th hole. He walks up and looks at my ball marker and it just had the Alamo on the top and he kind of like leans down and goes, is that the Alamo? And I'm like, yes, it is. Which I thought was hilarious because it's like so random that he looks down, he recognized the Alamo, and then he said it to me. So anyway, I got it when I went to a BYU versus Texas game and we stopped at the Alamo and my friend gave me this. So that's why I haven't. I thought it'd be funny at that point.
Yeah.
So anyway, it's just, I'll never forget that. Harris English hadn't said much so far the round, but then he looks at my ball marker and says,
Is that the Alamo?
So I use the Titleist glove. The leather's really nice on this. I really like how it feels, especially when you open up a new one after using like a really old one. Oh, it feels so good. All right, so this is my rangefinder that I use. Works great. You're not allowed to use rangefinders that have slope. So it has slope inside of it, so like you laser up a hill and say it's 130 yards, not counting the uphill, but it's 140 counting the uphill. You're not allowed to use the uphill. And then I just have a little club cleaner on my bag also.
That thing's never used, but you've got it.
What do you mean it's never used? I've used it like 5 times and I've had it for like 3 weeks. Yeah.
So there you go. There's Lincoln's bag. When you're in a tournament, do you carry it on your back or do you put it on a push cart?
There's some local tournaments that are like 9 holes and I do prefer to carry it on my bag, on my back. But in like 18 hole, 2 or 3 day tournaments, you definitely want a push cart.
Let me tell you a little bit about my golf bags. This is my golf bag I've been using lately. It is an M&M tour player's bag. This is not something that you would want to take and carry or put on your back.
There isn't even any strap on it.
It is so incredibly heavy. But when you're putting it on the back of a golf cart, it looks amazing and everybody sees your cart and they're like, M&M's.
He gets so many comments.
There's the M&M guy.
Yeah.
It is so cool. As far as driver goes, I've got the same driver as Lincoln, the TS2. And it's pretty good. Stiff shaft, something, even flow. I did get a new driver recently that I've been hitting a little bit. I do have 2 drivers that I've been trying out and that we leave in the golf simulator for when people come. They're the Sim and the Sim Max, TaylorMade. I think I like the Sim a little bit more. I don't know why, it just seems to hit better. This driver is longer than my Titleist one, so I'm still more comfortable with this one. I'm hitting it straight more often, but these are some nice drivers too. This is the same driver that Tiger Woods and Rory McIlroy uses along with other TaylorMade players, so I'm like, if it's good enough for Tiger, it's gotta be good enough for me. I also use TaylorMade clubs. It's called M6. I just got them last year. I've always used TaylorMade irons. In 2006, I just got out of college. I got my first ever pair of clubs and they were TaylorMade. And then last year, this is my upgrade, the M6 TaylorMade irons. They're a lot more forgiving than like some blade clubs because I'm not the greatest of golfers ever. For a 3-wood, I've always had this one, which is Rocket Balls. And I just upgraded to the Sim Max. It's a Sim Max 3-wood. This thing absolutely demolishes it.
Yeah, you hit that one so good.
I hit this so far and so straight. It's a 15 degree 3-wood. It's money. This is my favorite club in the bag, probably, I'd say right now. For putters, I have this White Ice Odyssey. You really can't find these many places, but I've been using it for years and it works really, really well. I did recently also get the TaylorMade Spider and I've been trying that one, but I'm definitely more comfortable with the one that I've had in my bag forever. So I'm still trying to get used to using the newer, fancier putter, but I love this thing. This is the golf ball that I'm using. It's the TaylorMade TP5. It's similar to what Lincoln uses. He uses the TP5, but his are called the Pix with the orange pizza thing on it. These ones are cool because they say what's inside on them. Here's the deal with the TP5s. We have a ton of them. I actually have eight dozen, whatever that is. I'm gonna give these away.
Whoa!
Giving away, if you want a what's inside TaylorMade TP5 golf ball, one of the ones that we have here, we'll put a link in the description. We'll have it on there and you can win some of these golf balls. So, if you want some golf balls, put a link in the description. We also do have a Pepsi bag that's just for inside of here in the actual golf room.
It's really nice. Can you explain how it's really nice having a tour bag?
The reason why we have these tour bags, these are like the bigger ones, is because when you're in the golf studio, this bag right here, this right there, this one has like a bunch of random clubs, like this wobbly stick thingy, some training tools, some drivers, Lincoln's old Titleist driver, basically clubs for guests when they come or training tools. And it makes it a lot easier. It takes up way less space when you can set it up tall like this and it's bigger on the inside. So that's originally why I even got this one. So I could just set it off to the side in here and it wouldn't take up space inside the simulator. The problem is I like having my clubs in there. So whenever we go golfing, I just take it with me. I put it on the back of the cart, we've got it. But the Pepsi bag, the M&M bag, we just bought these and we have them here at the place.
All right, so there's Lincoln's bag, there's my bag, there's a bunch of golf balls we're giving away. Yep. Lincoln, what's your goal this summer for golf?
To make the high school team and play in half of the tournaments. So take the top 6 spots in the high school team. That's the goal.
Ooh, that's a big goal.
That's
That would be awesome. What's inside of Lincoln's golf bag? There it is. You also saw a bonus of what's inside of my golf bag. And we've got TaylorMade golf balls. If you'd like them, the link is in the description. I hope that you're out golfing and you're having fun. Let us know in the comments. If you golf, Lincoln is playing way better than last summer, and I'm going to film some of his golf tournaments and put them on like I did last year.
If you guys do want
it. If you want to see it, let us know in the comments, but I want to film some of them. I just haven't wanted to do it for the first 3 weeks because I know he's just getting into it. I don't want him to have additional pressure, but it's time. It's time. I'm just going to film some of his rounds and post them on here. For those of you that want us to create a separate golf channel, sorry, we're not going to do that. This is our channel, family channel. We post a lot of family stuff on here, but happy golf season. Okay. There's the golf bag.
Happy golf season.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.